Gangadhar from diamond. See, the series questions are from 11 to 15. First, 11th question. To identify the basic terms, let us take the difference between the given terms. The difference between 2 and 123 is 121. And the difference between these two numbers is 100. This is 121, this is 100. Okay? So you just take it as 11 square, and this is 10 square, maybe 9 square, maybe 8 square, and there it is. Check the difference between these two. The difference between these two numbers is clearly 368 plus 49 gives 4. So this is 11 square, this is 10 square, this is 7 square. And this gap must be 981. So difference is 440 is the difference, okay. And we don't know this difference as well as this difference, and let us check the difference between these two, and this difference is given as 55, okay. The difference between these two values is what? This is 34 and 21, which is 55. So this is 880, 440, 55. So 880 lo half 440, 440 lo half 210, 210 lo half 110, 110 lo half 55. So this number must be 220. So 1336 plus 220 will give us 556 as the missing term of the series. Okay. And the next one is 1946, 110, 235 missing term. 94, we reiterate this. The same pattern, let us take the difference between these two values. The difference between 19 and 46. Okay. 19 and 46 is nothing but 27. 26 plus 1, 27. And coming to here, the difference between these two values is 64. And the difference between these two values is 125. If you see, this is 3 cube, this is 4 cube, this is 5 cube. So surely this difference will be 6 cube, which is 216. So your next term of the series is 235 plus 216, which is 4. This difference 179 and 258, if you check, the difference will be 79. This 25 can be expressed as 5 square minus 2, 34 can be expressed as 6 square minus 2, okay, and this 79 can be expressed as 9 square minus 2. 5 square minus 2, 6 square minus 2, 9 square minus 2, then this is 7 square minus 2, this will be 8 square minus 2. 7 square is 49 minus 2 is 47. 70 plus 47, 117 is the missing term of the series. Okay, so that was 14. And then coming to the final series question, 15th one, it is given that 679, 1230, 2332, 3985, and the question mark 8944. Let us check the differences again. Okay, what is the difference between 679 and 1230? The difference between 679 and 1230 we need to calculate. If you check, the difference between those two values is something like 10 minus 9 is 1, and this will be 2, 12 minus 7 is 5, and then 11 minus 6 is 5, that was 551 is the difference. And then coming to this difference, 1230 and 2332. 2 minus 0 is 2, 3 minus 3 is 0, 3 minus 2 is 1, 2 minus 1 is 1, which is nothing but 551 into 2 is 1102. Okay? And then coming to here, if you take the difference, 5 minus 2 is 3, 8 minus 3 is 5, 9 minus 3 is 6, 3 minus 2 is 1, 1653 is 551 into 3. This is 551, this is 551 into 2, this is 551 into 3, then surely this difference will be 551 into 4. The difference is 551 into 4. We need to identify the heuristic term of the series as 6189. Okay? Then from 16 onwards, we have the usual questions. 16th problem is given like this. The soldiers in two armies, when they met in a battle, are in the ratio 10 is to 3. Okay, the number of soldiers in the two armies are given as 10x and 3x. Their respective losses were as 20 is to 3. So the number of loss of the soldiers has led them as 20y and then 3y. And the survivors as 40 is to 30, the remaining persons. Okay, since in the first battle, the number of the army soldiers in the army is 10x and the number of losses is 20y and the survivors, the remaining soldiers are some 40 is to 13, and it is given that if the number of survivors in the larger army be 24,000, okay, find the number of soldiers in each army. See, as per the problem for the 16th one, 10x as well as 3x is the number of soldiers in the army and the losses are 20 is to 3, 20y and 3y, and it is given that in the first army the number of survivors are 24,000, in the second army the number of survivors are 13 parts of the 53. Okay, see, this is 40 is to 13, the ratio between the survivors is given as 40 is to 13, so 40 parts is 24,000, 13 parts we need to calculate, so 13 into 24,000 divided by 40 will give us the number of survivors in the second case. If you calculate, this value will be what? 2600. Okay? Not like that. See, this is 3x minus 3y, okay? And then do 0 and 0 will get cancelled. Okay? 4, 6, 13, 6 is 78, 7, 8, 0, 0. Now, this is 10x minus 20y, 3x minus 3y. Divide the value with 10, divide this value with 3. What will happen? X minus 2y is equals to 2400, and in this case x minus y is equals to, okay, 3 2s and then 3 6, 2600. X minus 2y is 2400, x minus y is 2600. If you add these two, okay, do subtraction, minus plus minus, these two will get cancelled. Minus 2y plus y is minus y, and this is minus 200. From there you will get that y is equals to 200, and then x is equals to 2800. Since x is 2800, the number of soldiers in the two armies has 10 into 2800, 3 into 2800, and your answer is 28,000 and 8,400. Okay, there are 16th problem. Then coming to 17th problem, it is given that Mr. X and Mr. Y entered into partnership business with investments 3 is to 7. After 3 months, X invests 1/4 of his capital, and then Y withdraws 1/5 of his capital. If the profit at the end of 15 months was 1.6 lakhs, find the share of Mr. X. Okay, otherwise, find the ratio between Mr. X and Y. Okay, as per the options, we need to calculate the ratio between X and Y. Okay, initial investments of the X and Y are 3 is to 7. Let them as 3K and 7K. After 3 months, X invests 1/4 of the capital, B withdraws 1/5 of the capital. So for the first 3 months, X invests 3K as well as Y invests 7K. Their initial investments ratio is 3 is to 7. After 3 months, okay, 3K for 3 months, 7K for 3 months. After 3 months, what will happen? X invests 3K plus 3K by 4, 1/4 of his capital, okay, for the remaining 12 months, because we are calculating the ratio or the investment is for 15 months, okay? Whereas Y withdraws 1/5 of his capital. So his capital is 7K, 1/5 is minus 7K by 5 into 12. This is what we need to simplify. If you simplify this, you will get the ratio as 30 is to 49. So the investments ratio as well as the profits ratio between X and Y is 30 is to 49. There ends the problem, okay?
Whereas coming to 18th problem, it is given that price reduction of 50 paisa per dozen eggs made to get dozen more eggs for 66 rupees. Find the original price of the eggs per dozen anamata. See, let the original and reduced price as some O and R. O is the original price and the red R be the reduced price. Okay. Price reduction of 50 paisa. So as per the first condition, the difference between the original price and the reduced price is 50 paisa, which is nothing but 1 by 2, half rupee. Okay. And since the original price is 0 per dozen, for 66, the number of X, the number of dozens is 66 by R, the reduced price, minus, and 66 by O will give us the number of dozens of X at the original price. The difference between these two is 1 dozen. Okay. So price reduced, 1 dozen X vastunnayi kabatti, number of dozens after reduction, number of dozens before reduction, the difference is 1. Solving these two, we will get the value of the O, which is original price. Okay. How can we do? If you do cross multiplication here, okay, 66 is the common task. 66 into O minus R is equals to O into R, if you took LCM. Okay, O minus R is 1 by 2. 66 into 1 by 2. 66 into 1 by 2 is equals to O into, replace R with O minus 1 by 2. Okay, if you simplify, you will get a quadratic equation in terms of O, and if you solve it, you will get the value of O as 6. So 6 rupees is the original price per dozen for X. Okay, there ends the problem. Then coming to 19th problem, it is given that in some quantity of ghee, 60% is pure ghee and 40% is vanaspati. If 10 kg of pure ghee is added, then strength of vanaspati ghee becomes 20%. Find the original quantity. We are 10 kg of pure ghee is added. That means the quantity of vanaspati is constant. Okay. Before adding, there is 40% of vanaspati and we don't know the quantity. So let 40% of X kgs is equals to, after adding 10 kg of pure ghee, the vanaspati becomes 20%. 40% of X is equals to 20% of X plus 10. Okay. By solving this line, you will get the value of X as again 10. Okay, so the initial quantity is also 10 kgs. Then coming to 20th problem. Samantha sells coffee at a profit of 12%. At a profit of 12%, so selling price is 112% of the cost price, let it as X. If she reduces the price by 29 rupees per case, minus 29 will give us the new selling price, which gives a loss of 17%. 17% loss means 100 minus 17, 83% of X. We need to calculate the initial selling price per kg of the coffee. Initial selling price. First of all, find X. And then the initial price is 112% of X. See, this is 112% of X. This is 83% of X. 17 and 12. So this 29 is nothing but 29% of X. So 29% of X is 29. From there, you will get X is equals to 100. So cost price is 100. And the initial selling price is 112% of 100, which is 112. That was your answer. Okay. Then coming to 21st problem. For 21st problem, it is given that a trader allows a discount of 10%. Okay. How much percent above the cost price must he mark his goods to make a profit of 10%? Okay. See, cost price, initially take it as X and then market price. They mentioned that how much percent above the cost price must the market price is taken? Okay. See, this market price is some question mark percent more than the cost price. On the cost price, there is a profit of 10%. And on the market price, there is a discount of 10%. Then this is the selling price. See, since it is 10%, so the selling price will be 110% of X. And since the discount is 10%, then selling price is 90% of the market price. And that market price is 100 plus question mark percent of X. 110% of X is equals to 90% of 100 plus question mark percent of X. Solve it to get the value of question mark. Okay. Percent of X will get cancelled. On solving, you will get the value of question mark as 200 by 9. And your answer is 22/9%. Okay. Then coming to 22nd problem. It is given that the compound interest on a certain sum of money for 3 years at 10% per annum is 662. Okay, then find the simple interest on the same sum at the same rate and the same time. Okay, see, compound interest is given. compound interest is nothing but amount minus principal. Amount is P into 1 plus rate of interest is given as 10%, okay? 10 by 100 power 3 minus P. See, 0, 0 will get cancelled. 10 plus 1 is 11. 11 cube by 10 cube. That means 1331 P by 1000 P minus P. 1000 minus P. On simplification, you get that 331 P by 1000. This difference, this compound interest is given as 662. 331 twos. And then principal will become 2000. Principal is 2000. Rate of interest is 10%. Time is 3 years. And then if you calculate simple interest for this, your answer will be 600. Okay? There ends this 22nd problem. Then coming to 23rd. A cistern has two taps, which fill it in 12 minutes and 15 minutes respectively. There is also a waste pipe in the cistern. When all the three are opened, the empty cistern is full in 20 minutes. The tank is full in 20 minutes. Okay? First tap will work in 1 minute. That means in 1 minute, the first tap will fill 1 by 12th part of the tank. And the second tap will fill 1 by 15th part of the tank in 1 minute. Whereas the waste pipe will empty 1 by xth part of the tank in 1 minute. Okay? See, in 1 minute, as per the schedule, 1 by 20th part is filled. Okay? So, on solving this, you will get the value of x as 1 by x as 1 by 10 and x as 10. So, waste pipe will empty 1 by 10th part of the tank in 1 minute. There ends the problem. Okay? Whereas coming to 24th problem, they ask us to calculate the unit digit of 7 power 2012, which is nothing but 7 power 4 multiple. Okay? See, 7 power 4 multiple. 7 square is 49. 7 power 4 multiple means 49 into 49, which ends with 9981. Okay? So, 7 power 4 multiple always ends with 1. So, your answer is 1. There ends the problem. Whereas coming to 25th problem, it is given that the average of 5 numbers is 27. So, the sum of the 5 numbers is 5 into 27. If one number is excluded, so minus 5, the average becomes 25. So, if one number is excluded, the remaining numbers are 4 and their average is 25. We need to calculate x. 27 into 5, 100 and then 35. 135 minus 100 and the value of x is 35. So, the excluded number is 35. There ends the problem. Okay. Then, from 26 to 30, okay, a pie diagram and a tabular data is mentioned regarding the percentages of employees in 7 departments like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, okay, and then percentage of males is mentioned in a tabular data, okay. So, pie diagram represents the percentage of employees in 7 departments out of the total number of employees, whereas the tabular data indicates the percentage of males in each individual department, okay. Coming to 26th problem, it is given that if the number of male employees in department A is 12160, okay, as per the table, the number of male employees in department A is 38%. So, 38% of A, that will give us 12160, okay. Then, they ask us to calculate the number of employees in department D, okay. Number of employees in department A, 16% of total employees. In department D also, 16% of total employees. That means the number of employees in A and D are same. So, if you calculate the number of employees in A, that is equals to the number of employees in D. So, 38% of A is 12160. From there, we need to calculate the value of A. If you calculate A, that was your answer. If you simplify, A will be 32,000. So, the number of employees in A as well as D is equals to 32,000. Okay, there ends the 26. Then coming to 27th problem, it is given that if the number of employees in department D is 32,000, number of employees in department D, that means 16% is corresponds to 32,000. So, 1% is corresponds to 2,000. They ask us to calculate the number of male employees in department B. So, in B, there are 15% employees. So, 1% is 2,000, 15% means 30,000. Number of male employees in B, as per the tabular data, the number of male employees in B are 52%. So, your answer will be 52% of 30,000. Okay, there ends the problem. Whereas coming to 28th problem, find the ratio of male employees in department F to that in department C. Okay, coming to department F, the number of male employees is mentioned as 46%. Okay, so 46% of the number of employees in F, which are 20%, 21% of total employees. Okay, to the number of male employees in department C, which is nothing but 42% of 11% of the total employees. So which is nothing but 46 into 21 divided by 42 into 11, 21 twos to 23s, and the ratio is 23:11. Okay, there ends the problem. Then coming to 29th, it is given that if the number of male employees in department A is 12160, then find the number of employees in department E. As per the first problem, 38% of A is 12160, and from there if you calculate A, you will get that A is equals to 32,000. This 32,000 is corresponds to 16%. They ask us to calculate the number of employees in department E. Department E is of 11%. Okay, so 11 into 2,000, which is nothing but 22,000 is the number of employees in department E. There is the problem. Okay, whereas coming to 30th problem, the number of employees in department B is given as 30,000. So in department B, which is 15%, is corresponds to 30,000. So 1%, it corresponds to 2,000. Okay. In the next year, the number of employees in departments B and G increase by 10% each. Then find the number of male employees in department G in the next year. Okay. See, then the number of employees in department G. As per the pie diagram, the number of employees in department G is 10%. 1% is 2,000, 10% is 20,000. Okay. Next year, it is increased by 10%. So the number of employees are 22,000. And we are going to calculate the male employees of G in the next year. Male employees is 58%. So 58% of 22,000 is your answer for 30th problem. Okay. There ends the problem. Right. Then coming to 31 to 35, a line graph is given which is indicating the profit percentages from 2005 to 2009. Okay. See. And the problem is about the incomes and expenditures. Okay. See, always we know that income is equals to expenditure plus profit. Income is equals to expenditure plus profit, and then profit percentage is calculated always on what? Expenditure. What? Profit percentage is profit by expenditure into 100. Profit means income minus expenditure divided by expenditure into 100. This is mentioned as a formula here. Okay. See, and then since profit is profit percent of the expenditure, then we will write that income is equals to E plus, okay, otherwise some 100 plus P percent of expenditure. Okay, these are the formulas related to income and expenditure, just like selling price and cost price with the profit percentage. Using these, we can solve the questions. Okay, coming to 31st problem, what is the average percent profit earned by the company over the years? We need to calculate the average profit percent earned by the company over the years. The profit percentage is given as 25 in 2005, 50 in 2006, 70 in 2007, 45 in 2008, 65 in 2009. If you add all these, you will get the summation as 255. To get the average profit percentage, divide with 5 and your answer is 51. There ends the problem. Okay. Then coming to 32, if the expenditure of the company in the year 2006 was 75,000, what was the ratio of the income to the expenditure of the company in the year? Okay, coming to 2007, okay. No, 2006. The problem is related to 2006. In 2006, the profit percentage is 50. Since the profit percentage is 60, we will write the income is equals to 150% of expenditure. They asked us to calculate the ratio between income and expenditure, which is nothing but 150 by 100. Okay, 150 by 100 is nothing but 3 by 2. 3:2 is your answer. There ends the problem. Okay. Then coming to 33rd problem, the profit percent earned by the company in the year 2009 is what was the percent of the percent profit earned by the company in the year 2005? In the year 2009, the profit percentage is 65. In the year 2005, the profit percentage is 25. 65 is what percentage of 25 we need to calculate. So for that, we need to calculate 65 divided by 25 into 100. 25 fours, 4 into 65, 240 plus 20, 260% is your answer. Okay, there ends the problem. Then coming to 34th problem, it is given that the incomes of the company, if the income of the company in the year 2005 and the 2007 was 680,000. Okay, so the incomes in both the years is same. For 2005, the profit is 125%. So income is 125% of the expenditure, that is equals to 6,80,000. In the second case, in 2007, the profit is 70%. So income is 170% of the expenditure. This is again is equals to 6,80,000. Solving this, we will get E1. On solving this, we will get E2. They asked us what was the difference in the expenditures of the company. So calculate E1 and E2 and took the difference between these two. That was your answer. Okay, they earned 34. Then coming to 35, if the profit earned by the company in the year 2008 was 90,000, the profit value is given as 90,000. In 2008, from the line graph, the profit percentage is 45%. So profit is profit percentage of the expenditure. So 45% of the expenditure is 90,000. From there, we can calculate the expenditure value as 2 lakhs. Okay. So what was the income of the company in that year? In that year, expenditure is 2 lakhs, profit is 90,000. Income is 2,90,000. That was your answer. Okay. Then on the completion of this data interpretation, we need to discuss the questions from the approximations as well as from the equations. Okay. See, let us take the first problem, which is given that 3/7 into 4/9 into 2/5 into 3/7, 1/9. Okay. See, solve it completely exactly to get the answer as 283. Okay. Whereas coming to second problem, 0.008, okay, 0.008 plus 6.009 divided by 0.7 square. 0.7 square is 0.49. 0.49 is approximated as 1/2. So 6 by something divided by 1/2 is approximately 12. On neglecting this, your approximate value is 12. There ends the problem. Okay. Whereas coming to third problem, cube root of 95,647. See, the cube root of 95,657 is approximately 45. Okay. 45 into 7 divided by 3.8 into 5.5. Okay. If you simplify, you will get the approximate value is nearly 16. Okay. See how remove these differences and then took that 100. So that means write it as 38 into 55 into 100. 5 nines, 5 elevens, 11 nines. And then, and after that, 9 9 is 81, and this will be 7 5 is 35, and then 30, approximately 37, 4 is 28, 5.4 something. Something like 81 by 5.4 something, I approximate value 16 point something. So, options right there, maybe the question was mistake, okay? Then, coming to the next problem, so on complete simplification, you will find the approximate value as 1, okay? For the fourth problem, it is given that 98 into 785 divided by 285 into 285, we need to simplify. Okay. See, if you check, approximately 98 threes is 285. And then on cancelling 785 and 285 with 5, okay, 5 ones is 5, and then 28, 5 fives is 25, and then 35, and this is 157. Okay, and then coming to here, 285, 5 5 is 25, 35, 5 7 is 35. 157 by 57, if you check approximately, this is 3, approximately. So 3 point something by 3 is approximately equals to 1. Among the options, the value approximately equals to 1 is 0.9, and that was your answer. Whereas coming to the next problem, square root of 749 is approximately some 27 into 1/2 plus 14. So approximate value is 14 plus something like 13 point something, approximately 27.5. That means more than 27 and your approximate value is 30. Okay, there ends the problem. Whereas coming to 6 to 10, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, the problems related to quadratic equations. By solving the given equations, we have to find the values of x and y. And after finding the values of x and y, we need to compare the values. Okay. Then coming to sixth problem, the first equation is given that 5x square minus 87x plus 378 is equals to 0. For this, we need to calculate the values of x. So let us take the difference between these two, product of these two. 5 into 378 can be expressed as something like 2 into 189. Okay, this 189 can be expressed as 9 into 21. And at the end, this can be expressed as 9 5 is 45 and then 42. 45 into 42 is this product. 45 plus 42. And let us take the minus 45 minus 42. Minus 45 minus 40. The summation is minus 87. The product is this value. So the values of x are, just change the symbols, 45 and 42. Divide with the x square coefficient by 5 and by 5. 45 by 5 is 9. 42 by 5 is something like 8.4. The values of x are 9, 8.4. Whereas come to the second equation, which is given that 3y square minus 49y plus 200 is equals to 0. To calculate the values of y, take the product of these two, which is 600. Express this 600 as the product of 24 and 25. Since it's minus 49, minus 24, minus 25. The product is 600, whereas the summation is minus 49, and the values of y are, change the symbols, 24, 25, divide with 3. 24 by 3 is 8, 25 by 3 is 8 point, some 10, 3 something. This is 8.3, this is 9.8.4. Both the values of y are less than x, that means x is greater than y, and your answer is option A. Okay. In the same pattern, we can solve the remaining quadratic equations, and then we compare the values of x and y. Whereas coming to the ninth problem, okay, the problem is related to the linear equations. Okay, instead of quadratic, there a relation between x and y is given in terms of a pair of linear equations. Solving those, we get the values of x. Okay. For the ninth problem, it is given that 3x plus 2y is 301, whereas 7x minus 5y is 74. To calculate the value of x, what we do? Multiply the first equation with 5. If you multiply 15x plus 10y is equals to 1505. Whereas multiply the second equation with 2, then it will become 14x minus 10y is equals to 148. If you add these two will get cancelled. 29x is equal to sum of these two values is 1653. So on division, x is nothing but 57. 1653 divided by 29 is 57. Since the value of x is 57, replacing the value of x in this equation, from there you will get the value of y as 65. X is 57, y is 65, so x is less than y, and that was your answer. Okay. In the same pattern, we can solve the 10th problem, which involves with the quadratic equations. After finding the values of x and y, we compare the values of x and y. There ends the problem. Okay. So finally, this is the explanation for the quantity two questions from the IBPS PO second paper. Thank you. Thank you very much.